Howdy. Y'all come on in, grab a seat. We're going to get this little shindig started. Y'all ready up there, Miss Cheryl? It said zero, so I went.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Jasper County Cowboy Church. I got a herd of Watusie cattle behind me eating, and you can see there's horns for days back there. But we want to welcome you to Jasper County Cowboy Church. If you don't have a church home, we say welcome home. And we want to let you know that JC3, Jasper County Cowboy Church, is truly a church like nowhere else. You may see my horse Peanut in church one Sunday. You may see no telling what. There may be a zebra in here on April the 7th. So think about that. Grab a bulletin when you come in the front door or when you go out. Make sure you get a bulletin and let you know what's going on. As you leave church today, where the donuts were earlier this morning, there'll be team sign-ups. You can sign up for a team, put your name and phone number, and we'll get in touch with you. Also, at Cowboy Church, we do things a little bit different, all right? We don't pass the hat at Cowboy Church. We have little wooden churches in the back of the auditorium, one in the foyer on the right. That is where you give your tithes and offerings if God puts it on your heart. And really, I just want to say thank you for your faithful giving. We do a lot of big outreaches. You're going to see one of the busiest churches in the country. Even if you're a visitor, hang around a little while. You're going to see a lot. We have a lot of volunteerism in our church. Probably 70% of our people serve somewhere. And we keep them busy. So thank you for your faithful giving. We couldn't do what we do if we all didn't do our part. Easter is next Sunday. We'll have two services, 8:30 and 10:30. If you're an early bird, come to the early service. Or even if you're going to serve in the late service, 10:30, come to church. That way you can enjoy it with your family. So we'll have free breakfast served before both services. So that's going to be good. The nursery will be open. The buckaroos will be open for both services. So we're looking forward to Easter. Get your hit list. Start inviting people. I know you already have, but bring them with you. Today, we're going to do baby dedications here a little bit later in the service, March the 24th. So if you have a child you want to dedicate to the Lord, I'll be getting with you in a few minutes, and we'll get that done. Buckaroos, they put out a cattle call for next Sunday, which will be Easter. They need stuffed Easter eggs. We got a bunch already. We got a giving, working church, so thank you. But if you hadn't got some stuffed Easter eggs in, get with Miss Debbie Daniel, and she'll let you know. Speaking of Miss Debbie, that brings me to the Handy Capable Rodeo. It'll be April the 18th. That is one of the biggest things we do. Last year, we had 1,600 kids that were bused to the Handy Capable Rodeo. They got to ride a horse, ride a wagon, do all kinds of cool stuff. That's why we love our church. We think outside the box. We do things and try to bless other people. So Handy Capable Rodeo will be April the 18th on a Thursday. We're going to have a meeting on April the 7th, right after church, for the Handy Capable Rodeo. Miss Debbie is in need of a tent, so if you have a tent, get with somebody and they'll hook you up with Miss Debbie Daniel. Family Day in the arena, April the 6th. We're going to have a cool day on a Saturday from 3 to 5 p.m. You don't want to miss it. We're going to have a mechanical bull set up out there for anybody to ride. We're going to have a cow chip toss. We can get some cow chips right behind me. Lawnmower barrel races. Grease pig chase. It's going to be a lot of fun. We have a celebrity barrel race that you don't want to miss. Nobody really knows what it is. It's going to be good. So we'll see you April the 6th on a Saturday from 3 to 5 right here in the arena. Celebrate Recovery meets every Sunday afternoon at 5:30. It's open to the public now. It's out in the big multi-purpose building beside the church. This next Wednesday night, we're going to have an arena game night in the church arena. We're going to kick the lights on. So March the 27th, all the teenagers, that's where we're going to meet. As an incentive, I have encouraged the teenagers, the one that brings the most friends will get $100 cash minimum. I've had some people step up and help me with that. So a minimum of $100. And the second place teenager who brings the second most friends will get a minimum of $50. So it's an incentive for our youth. We'll have the arena lights on and we're going to have a good time. Amen? All right. Their ladies for the Handy Capable Rodeo are needing 2-inch sugar cookies or tea cakes. Only 2-inch. And they just want sugar cookies or tea cakes. No icing, no candies. 2 cookies per snack bag. And the reason we do that is for allergies and stuff. You can sign up at the welcome desk right out there in the foyer as you leave the church. The welcome wagon, you can get sign up there to help. The cookies will need to be at the church. That's the on the morning of April the 17th. So that's going to be good. So run through some of these announcements here. I'm reading this little deal, and we're going to get her done. We got a lot going on. I want you to enjoy the service today. It may be a song that's sang, maybe a smile. Somebody just smiles and looks you in the eye today. It may be a scripture that we share today. We always have so much fun at church. We draw closer to the Lord every day. I just encourage you to enjoy the service. Shut the world out in your mind and just let the Lord speak to you today in some unique way. If you are a visitor, we can't even tell you in words how happy and thankful we are that you chose to come worship with us. Y'all have a blessed day today and enjoy the service.
We're glad to see everybody here this morning. We got some stuff going on this morning, that's for dang sure. You want to welcome the visitors?
Absolutely. How many first-time visitors do we have with us today?
Raise your hand up. Get them up.
Y'all keep them up. They're going to bring you a goodie bag by. Make them feel welcome. We are glad that you are here today. And we have a walking, talking miracle that's got a birthday today. Y'all make Joe Henry feel welcome this morning. We love you, buddy. We're glad you're here. Come on up, kiddos.
That was my line.
Well, but you didn't say it.
Oh. Hey, you know what I did?
What'd you did?
About 6 months ago, I joined one of Anytime Fitness Center's thingies.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. I'm going to go back tomorrow and see if I can get my money back because it ain't worked.
Really? You got to go.
Where?
To this place.
It said Anytime Fitness.
You thought it was just going to magically appear, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that ain't the way it works. I bet they'll give you a full refund, though.
Nobody told me that. If y'all would, please stand and join us in the pledge. Salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now the Texas. Salute, pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
All right, y'all, who got the buckaroos this morning? Oh, I was going to say, I didn't see no hands going up, but now I see them. You need to stand up, Shorty. See, Kayla, you're not the only one I pick on.
Y'all ready to have church?
Yeah. Came from Galilee, carpenter by trade. Came to build his father's church on the plans that they had made. Destiny was Calvary, his mission would not fail. Built this church on a rugged cross, Rio was his name. This church is still standing, it will never fail, but stained its foundation. Against it, they will not prevail. He built this church on a rugged cross, three old rusty nails. Without bricks and stones, himself alone on everything it takes to build a church that will stand so strong when this old world begins to shake. A fool can build his building tall, but it will never fail. Compared to the church that Jesus built for three old rusty nails, this church is still standing. It will never fail. Blood stained its foundation, faith put up a wall. The world may come against it, they will not prevail. Built this church on a rugged cross, three old rusty nails. Yes, he built this church on a rusty cross, three old rusty nails.
All right, is anybody going to have a baby dedication today? Okay, we got one. Well, it was worth learning this song for. This is a special song. It's all about kids. And I'm sure 99.999% of us out there have kids. Written by the great Eddie Raven, recorded by the Oak Ridge Boys. Thank God for kids. Kids, have you ever thought there wouldn't be no Santa Claus? And look what the stork just brought. Thank God for kids. And we'd all live in a quiet house without Big Bird or a Mickey Mouse. No Kool-Aid on the couch. Thank God for kids. Amen. Thank God for kids. There's magic for a while. A special kind of sunshine and a smile. Do you ever stop to think or wonder why the nearest thing to heaven is a child? Daddy, how does this thing fly? And 100 other where's and why? I really don't know, but I try. Thank God for kids. And when I look down in those trusting eyes and look to me, I realize there's love that I can't buy. Thank God for King. Thank God for kids, there's magic for a while. A special kind of sunshine and a smile. Do you ever stop to think, I wonder why? The nearest thing to heaven is a child. When you get down on your knees tonight to thank the Lord for His guiding light, pray they turn out right. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids. Amen. Gotta love them. Thank you.
Why me, Lord? What have I ever done to deserve even one of the blessings I've known? Tell me, Lord, what did I ever do with worth lost from you and the kindness
now that I know
soul's in your hands. Jesus, my soul's in your God would give him a son. Blessed Isaac was his name, the greatest gift he'd ever known. Then came the day, who would have dreamed God would say, you gotta give him back to me. And on this mountain, you must prove that it's you and Isaac, or it's me and you. When I and Isaac standing in God's way. It's on this altar you too can prove that it's not your Isaac that God wants, but he wants you. When I lay my Isaac down with a broken heart, but my father's proud. And on this altar where he lay, just to find that it wasn't him, but God wanted me. When I lay my Isaac down with a broken heart, but my father's proud. And on this altar where he lay, just to find that it wasn't him, but God wanted me. On this altar where he lay, just to find that it wasn't him, but God wanted me.
All right, we're going to open this last song up as an altar call. If you've got a prayer need this morning, please come up. I'm going to ask the lay pastors, Miss Alice and Miss Joe. I'd like to forget that. Y'all don't wait on me. Folks, if you can't feel the Holy Spirit stirring this morning, I believe you would a little bit. If you'll come up here and get with one of these folks, though, they will help you dry it out. If you'd stand and worship with us. I thought that number one would surely be me. I thought I could be what I wanted to be. I thought I could build on life's sinking sand, but I can't. I'll make Jesus my one and my all. From now on, when I'm in trouble, only His name I'll call. If I couldn't trust Him, I'd be less of a man. Lord, I can't. Without you holding my hand, Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high, and the valleys too wide. Down to stop playing. Father, I come to you right now just as humbly as I know how. God, I feel your spirit in this place today. God, the ones that have come up this morning, Father, I just pray, God, that you would see them where they're at. Father, that you would give them every need that they're asking. Father, if there's one here today, God, that you're pulling on their heartstrings. Father, they're wanting to get right, God, but they just don't know how. God, I just pray that you would put that desire on their heart to talk to somebody. And God, as my brother, Pastor Chet, takes the stand, Father, I ask that you would just hide him behind the cross this morning. God, give him the words to say that we need to hear. God, I lift our military men and women up to you, our first responders. God, our doctors, our nurses, everyone that's in harm's way. Father, I just pray a special blessing on each. God, I ask now that you would go through the remainder of this service with us and on through life. Forgive us of sin and use us for your honor and your glory. And it's in your Son Jesus' precious name that I ask it all. Amen. Would you make welcome to the stage, Pastor Chet.
Amen. Everybody blessed? Amen. Good deal. All right, we're going to get ready. We got a big day planned here. We've already had church, amen. We just get to be around, hang around for the rest of it. I'm going to run through just a couple of quick announcements here that I want to bring out that we're doing them by video, but we're getting used to it. Those are done on Thursdays. We're going to send our buckaroos out, so let's give them a good hand clap. They hadn't already went up. Our buckaroos, we appreciate our kiddos. Some very important announcements here. Make sure, first off, I don't know if I mentioned this out there. How many of you like them old big horn Watusi cow? That's pretty cool. But one thing we do, we don't pass the hat at Cowboy Church. God puts it on your heart to give. There's wooden churches in the back and one in the foyer. Thank you for your faithful giving. Beulah, on April the 7th, I grew up in a little community. We got a lot of new people, but I grew up in a little community called Beulah. And every year they have a homecoming. It's a big deal. Jasper County Cowboy Church kind of helps keep their homecoming alive. So anybody that wants to go to Beulah that particular Sunday, we'll get with you. We have some directions online. It's easy. If you just type in Beulah, B-E-U-L-A-H, Community Center, on your maps, it'll take you right next door as a church. You can't miss it. But it is, bring a covered dish. It's old dinner on the grounds right after church. Amen. So if you want to go on April the 7th, I'm going to be there. And raise your hand if some of you are planning to come. We're going to have quite a few coming to Beulah. So it's always fun. It makes their day to fill the building up. Amen. A little small church. We're going to start a new round pen deal. Similar to a round pen, we're going to call it a back pen. Everybody say back pens. All right, when you talk to somebody at a bull ride and you say, well, he's over in the back pens, he's in pen so-and-so, it's going to be for pretty much 18 and up. It's for our college and career age, 18 years old or older, and Mr. Stephen's going to start teaching that class, so that's going to be good. Stand up, Stephen Bonner, do a backflip for us. But anyway, he's one of our elders. He's going to do that back pen class. It's going to be kind of cool. It's for they're the young adults, really. So 18 and above. Is it boys, girls, boys just right now? Young men right now. I should have said young men, right? And saddling up. I forgot to put this in there. We are going to do a saddling up class every 2 months. It's very similar to our old new members class. It will be April the 21st. If you have been to a membership class, that's fine. But if you haven't been to what we call a membership class, we're calling it saddling up. How many of you know when you saddle a horse, you're finna get something done? And so if you want to come to that saddle up class, it'll be April the 21st. You have to pre-register because we're going to have a meal. It's for new people that may not have been to the new membership class. Last time we had 48 people, which is really so many to get plugged in. We're just going to start doing it every 2 months. So even if it's two people, it's going to be good. So we're going to have some food. Can I get an amen? So we'll have a sign up for saddling up. If not, go to the welcome desk. Miss Beverly, stand up. She'll be at the welcome desk right after church, and she'll help you get signed up for the saddle up on April 21st. Sail Barn, you don't want to forget, they got shirts, caps, and buckles. This is a church buckle we designed several years ago. It's just a way to get the word out. We were in Woody's Truck Stop in Centerville, Texas. How many of you know where the beef jerky sold? Praise the Lord. That's how everybody knows where Woody's is. Me, I don't like it. I just stop there and eat it to make Allison happy. Amen. So we were at Woody's yesterday, and I had on my old, I'm talking about, wow, Jasper County Cowboy Church shirt. I was standing up there looking at something, and this lady said, "I like your shirt." And she said, "We go to Triple Cross Cowboy Church in Granbury, Texas." So isn't it cool that I tell you, get some shirts, do what you do. I do it all the time. My caps and shirts, it's just another way to plant a seed. And let's see. All right. Other than this Sunday, we're going to have, next Sunday is Easter Sunday. Everybody say amen. How many of you got a hit list? I want you to invite some people, bring them with you, hog time, whatever you got to do. We'll untie them when they get here. But we're going to do two services to make sure we have plenty of room, 8:30 and 10:30. This is the kicker. If you're an early bird, come to 8:30. We have a free breakfast for you. Amen? Come a little early. If you come to 10:30, come early. We're going to feed you a free breakfast. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
How many of you thankful we serve a risen Savior? Thank you, Lord. All right. So anyway, next Sunday's a big day. We're going to have a great service, but we're going to do two services just to make sure everything is comfortable, because we're going to be inviting some people. Amen. All right. Baby dedications. I've got a baptism or two and one baby dedication for sure. Anybody else dedicating a child other than Miss Amy? I want to make sure I don't miss nobody. We did have one. I don't see Eric and Tyler. Got some people out of town today, but they did theirs a couple of weeks ago. They just was ready to get it, do it. And a baby dedication is a special thing, because it's where we as parents dedicate our child and receive that child as a gift from God. Amen? Not only do we receive it as a gift from God, what do? We dedicate that child to God and say, "Lord, tighten us up. Do what you got to do to help us be a godly example." Do you realize how little of a godly example in our world today that we live in, that we see? There isn't a real good example at home sometimes, so it blesses my heart to see young people standing up for God. Can I get a good amen? Someone asked Miss Amy to come up here, and I'll tell you what, JC3, we have broad tent stakes, amen? And I want her to tell everybody your name. Your husband's working off on a oil rig. Her mom and dad are watching live. Can I get a good amen? Now, and you may have drove a ways from church, but that she drove from Nacogdoches, Texas to dedicate her child. So tell them your name and little man's name.
I'm Amy Cates, and this is Walker Cates, and I was a founding member at Jubilee, so Pastor Chet actually dedicated me, so that's why this is super important to me.
Think about that. How old were you probably? Your mama would know.
I think I was about his age.
About yay long.
His picture. I was looking at my picture, and I was about his size, maybe a little bit bigger.
And how old is little man?
He is almost 9 months.
What's his name again?
Walker James Cates.
Walker. All right. I like that.
Walker, I wanted a James good Southern Cates name.
That's good. Hey, they watch our service live. Her mom and dad are faithful watchers. They used to go to my church many, many years ago in Nacogdoches. And when she was that size, I dedicated her, or, you know, with her parents, dedicated her to the Lord. And God's had his hand on Amy and using her mightily. I saw her and her husband the other day in Atwoods. Allison says going anywhere with me is like going with the Pope. That ain't too funny, but that's what she... So we're in Atwoods, and we hear Pastor Chet ringing through Atwoods. And they, you know, her and her husband and little one here, they said, "Hey, ready for April 24th at dedicating our baby to the Lord." So I know everybody's watching, and Dad may be working, but he'll be watching later on. I want to share a scripture with you right quick. It is Psalms 127, verse 3. It's quick. I'm going to read it to you. It says, "Children are a gift from the Lord, and they are a reward from him." Can I get a good amen? And thank you for that song today. I don't know where Mr. George is sitting. There he is. But hey, that wasn't that a great song? Make you think about how kids are a blessing. Me and Allison was in Stephenville, Texas, Friday night, a spur of the moment trip. We're laying in the hotel bed at 11 o'clock, and I get a text from my oldest daughter, says, "Are you busy? I need advice." I'm like, even if I was, I'd tell you to call me. We love our kids, amen. And godly men and women I'm so proud, young people are dedicating their children to the Lord. So to dedicate our child to the Lord, Miss Amy, is basically just saying, this child is a gift from God. I understand that. I believe that. So I'm dedicating this child back to the Lord. And as parents, I am committing to raise this child in a godly home and be a godly example.
Yes, sir. He is a gift from God because we struggled for a long time to have a baby. So having him has been the greatest gift for both of us.
Now that's
he
pretty
wants
neat.
To say some words.
That's right. He's going to be a preacher. But
No, you can't put it in your mouth.
It looks like a big pacifier to me, said. The Lord has provided a huge passing. Amen. So, y'all had a little trouble having a child, but here we are.
Yes, sir.
He likes that mic.
He does. He's going to be a talker like me.
That's right. Well, I'm going to pray with y'all. And what we basically do, dedicating a child to the Lord is something that the parents do in their heart. But it's to do it publicly, it changes you. Amen. It's kind of like getting baptized. And you remember, I took a stand for God. So I'm going to pray with y'all. Lord, I just come to you. I thank you for Amy and Dad and little man here, Mr. Walker, and grandparents. We just, Lord, take a minute and think about Psalms 127. Children are a gift from God. We receive this child as a gift from you. And this family, Lord, commits for you to direct and guide them that they would raise this child in a godly home. They're taking a stand, Lord, to raise them in a Christian home. And on top of that, Lord, we ask you to direct and guide and correct us when we need it so we can be the example that you've called us to be. And I thank you for this little young man that would grow. He would grow up to be everything that you've called him to be and do everything you called him to do in Jesus' name. Everybody say it.
Amen.
Amen. We'll give it one last hug. Amen. Isn't that a great day when you... dedicate one to the Lord, now they're old enough to have one. James forgot his chew toy. Thank you, James. All right. Well, who we got getting baptized today? Where's our baptisms at? They're undercover on me or what? They hiding out. All right, we ready? If you're getting baptized, y'all come on this way. I got to get my microphone. Ain't many days go by that we don't do some baptisms. So I got a couple calls this week. It was good. Actually, last Sunday, a young lady come to me and said, I'm wanting to rededicate my life. Somebody sang a song. Actually, Miss Valerie. God can use anybody. God used donkeys in the Old Testament. Amen? But it may be a song. It may be a smile. It may be a handshake. It may just you being kind. It may be a scripture. But God uses some cool things to plant seed in people's lives. So this young man called me. What day was that? Do you remember?
Thursday.
And asked, when's the next time he could get baptized? I said, when's the next time we have church, Moses? He said, that sounds good to me. So introduce yourself. Kind of tell us what God's doing in your life.
My name's Moses Price. We've been going here for quite some time, going to JC3. I've taught a couple of men's round pen, and I went with the youth Wednesday to King's Court, and I spoke there, but I felt an urge that night to make a decision to get baptized.
So it was Wednesday night. I didn't get to go. I know Miss Allison went to King's Court, and they said it was real good. DC's out of town today, but he gave us a report and several people. So God's, I guess, worked on your heart at King's Court.
Yes, sir.
Amen. How many of you are proud of Mr. Moses? Got Mom here. You want to say anything, Mom?
I'm just proud of him.
She said, I'm just proud of him. Amen. Praise God. Thank God for kids. Amen. Well, Moses, I'm proud of you, brother. Hop on in there. First thing I'm going to ask you is Jesus Christ the Lord of your life? I know the answer, but I'm going to ask you. It's good to publicly confess that. Amen. All right. Kicked his boots off. Let's go. It don't matter. I'm right-handed, so spin around the other way. We're messing with you here. All right. Now you can just scoot forward. Thank the Lord for the new baptistry heater. Amen. It's nice in here. Amen. How many of you are proud of a young man 18 years old wanting to get baptized? Seems like our youth sometimes and teenagers, they're bolder than us grown folks sometimes. So proud of you, Moses, and on your confession of faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, it's now my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. There we go. Amen. Woo! There's your boots. Good job, my brother. I miss Ed up here with me. All right. Where's our young lady? Man, these baptisms are powerful. All right. This is Miss Haley. She came to me last Sunday morning. Said she wanted to meet about 10 o'clock. And we get in there, and somehow or another, some way, we got to be kidding. Because she got in there and started crying. I said, well, I know Jesus is in your heart because that's what he done to me. When I got saved, I turned into a crybaby. Amen. And it's okay if you're not, but I'm just saying I am, and I'm not ashamed of it. Amen. But she shared a little bit, so share on your heart because what you say will help somebody much more than if I just reiterate it. So.
I feel like the past few years, like I was baptized when I was little, and I just feel like the past few years I've grown away from God. And Miss Valerie actually sang a song a few weeks ago, and when I got in my car, I broke down. I didn't know what to do. I just turned to God and said, I need to give my life back to you. And so that's when I met with Pastor Chet, and I was like, I want to do this and live for him like I'm supposed to.
Now, and you went to a Christian concert last Sunday. How was that?
That was good.
That's good. She went to Bossier City to a Christian concert, so she's on fire for God. And tell us what the song was. Not that it matters, but it's funny how God speaks to us.
It was actually Where I Find God.
How many of you like that song? In a hayfield or a deer stand? God will meet you where you're at. See, God can be 1,000 steps away from you and me. When we take one, God takes 999. Mom, you want to say anything? You good.
Just want to say she's a college student, SFA. She works two jobs. This kid has been amazing. She has taught me so much just as her being my daughter. She has seen a lot of things that a child should never see. I'm very proud of her, and I'm very blessed that she has decided to give her life back to God.
Amen. Don't get no better than that. We good?
When I first met Haley, it was like a block. I mean, we wouldn't communicate, but now we have a better relationship, and I did ask her for her permission to marry her mom. I'm very proud of her taking this step.
Amen. You good, Granny? Miss Kim, she's good. She said, I'm tapping out, Pastor. Amen. Miss Haley, Jesus live in your heart? I know he does, but it's good to confess it out loud. So just step over in there and face your mom. And you can sit down right there. Man, this is a great day. Young people coming to Jesus. Amen. We don't care what age, but it blesses my heart. Gives me hope for the next generation. Amen. So, Miss Haley, on your confession of Jesus Christ being the Lord of your life, it's my privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Woo. We always give these keychains away, so I'm going to get Mr. Randall or somebody to find Moses. But that's a keychain with a mustard seed in it. And that mustard seed represents that is how much faith we have to have. And a mustard seed is pretty small. Amen? So it doesn't take a lot. He just said the faith of a mustard seed. I'm going to talk y'all out of a towel over there in a minute. Yeah. Well, that's in front of me, James. We're going to work our direction here. I'm just messing with you, James. Anybody chew on a chew toy at church, tough. All right. All right, here we go. Everybody blessed this morning. Amen. How many of you already had good church service? Let me see that, Mr. Ed. I may have to use it a little more. Oh, shirt's wet. I love getting wet shirts. All right. I was going to throw it on his head and let him walk out. All right. Amen. Everybody blessed today? All right. If you have your Bible, we'll open our Bibles to Matthew chapter 16. Y'all know today is Palm Sunday, amen? And really, Palm Sunday makes me think about the selfless love that Christ showed for me. They laid palm leaves out before him. And this is a joke. Everybody say, I love my pastor. My folks out here love their pastor, amen? And it's very, Cowboy Church is so different. I got saved in April of 19 in a Cowboy Church in the gravel parking lot. And we were cowboy, we were just, you don't have to be a cowboy, it's just, we country folks, amen? If you live in Southeast Texas, you're country. You ain't got no choice. Amen, you're going to have a touch of country in you. Cowboy Church is a little bit different, but they told us in Bible school one time that Jesus, being a pastor, was kind of like Jesus. When Jesus rode into Jerusalem, they laid down palm leaves for him, and they said, blessed is he who comes in the what? Name of the Lord. 7 days later, they said, they screamed, crucify him. Now, we don't have that as a pastor, but think about the life of Jesus. He came into that city, and they laid down palm leaves. He knew where he was going. He wasn't going to be some famous person. He was going to be nailed to a cross, humiliated, spat upon, crown of thorns shoved on his head, his beard plucked out. And all these things that he faced, he willingly done that for me. Can I get a good amen? So I think about the selfless love of my Savior. So we're going to get rolling here and we'll go quickly. Let's pray. Lord, speak to our hearts today. Thank you for all these people, dedication babies to the Lord. Thank you for every person that was baptized that took a public stand in their faith for Jesus Christ. Lord, may we never take that for granted. In Jesus' name, everybody said? Amen. You know how many churches would love to baptize 2 people all year long? And there's some that baptize 200. My point is, be thankful when God blesses us with people. Amen? I mean, before we eat dinner today, we are to say, Lord, thank you for these people, the young people that dedicated their child to the Lord. Thank you for these young people, 18 and 19, that were publicly baptized today, Lord. Thank you, God, before you even eat today. Thank him for those people and pray that God would watch over and protect them. We have to pray one for another. Amen? All right, I got a question for you today. My mouth's dry, I got to get me a drink. Here we go. My question is, are you broke, or are you green broke? How many of you know what a green broke horse is? That's a nice way of telling you you're going to get your butt thrown off, probably. Or run into a limb, or run up under a clothesline. You ever heard the theory, well, he's green broke. That means anything that happens to you with this horse after you take him is not on me. In other words, he knows a wee little bit most of the time. And then there are those horses that you would say, man, that horse is broke. Peanut's one that I would say is broke. you know, and there's a lot of horses probably better than her. I don't know of any. I'm just joking, but that's my horse. I love Peanut. Amen. But are you broke, really broke, or are you green broke? And the only way you're going to find out if you're a green broke Christian is you're going to have something happen to you that rocks your world. So that's where you're going to find out. All horses are gentle when they're standing there eating out of a tub and nothing's happening around them a lot of time. But a horse will be exposed to a lot of different things, and as a Christian, we will too. So let's look at Matthew chapter 16, and we're going to go quickly into these verses, verse 24. It says, "Then Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you wants to be my," what's that next word? Follower. Raise your hand if you want to be a follower of Christ. Obviously, you wouldn't be here if you didn't. He said, if anyone wants to be my follower, don't you wish it did? Just sit down in your easy chair, and I'm going to push the massage button on your recliner and enjoy the rest of your life. If any of you wants to be my follower, you must give up your... That's where the mule throwed Tony. Anybody ever heard that? Anybody ever heard that phrase? My mama used to say that when I was a little boy. Something would go haywire, and she'd say, well, now that is where the mule throwed Tony. Apparently, somebody in Beulah was named Tony, and he was popular, and he rode a mule, and the mule threw him. And when you get throwed, it's an experience you don't kind of wish you could forget, but you can't. So he says, if anyone wants to be my follower, you must give up your own way. You know how hard that is? I don't never have any plans. Oh, let's see. Chet, or Simeon. Is that Simeon under that hat? Come up here. I ain't whooped nobody with a halter and a long. I'm joking. He said, I'll take it away from you, boy. I'm getting older, and these guys are always younger. Now, just going to use this rope part of the halter for just a second. I'm going to read again. Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you wants to be my follower, you must give up your own way. We're just going to stop right there. Let's just say that I am going to represent the Lord, and Simeon is going to represent a young, hard-headed man. Now, that doesn't relate to him, right? He's just filling in for you guys. And his mom said, amen. Now, Simeon's a good boy. So what I'm going to do here is you're going to just act like a typical human Christian that we give our life to Jesus, and we're going to say that God is, you know, God's actually in this halter, and he's pulling us. And what is Simeon? He's looking back. He dropped the rope. How many of us done that? Nobody wants to raise their hand, but that's okay. Now, you know, get you a good hold on it, and I'm going to ask you to go with me, and you kind of drag your heels a little bit. I mean, go show enough, drag them. Sit back on it. See, and I'm trying to lead him to the path of righteousness' sake, and look at him. Get both hands and kind of lean back on it. There you go. I feel him now. Now, what's he doing? And will God lead you down the wrong road? But how many of us, Lord's... Today, probably, not last week. Let's don't look at our neighbor. If you're married and want to stay married, don't look at them right now, all right? So let's just say God's pulling on you. And you know what we're doing? You ever seen an old cow or a horse with the whites of their eyes roll back? All you can see? Ignorant. I've seen people tie a show steer to a tractor because it drug humans all around. I'm like, come on, get you some of this John Deere now, baby. And that's when you see the whites of them eyes. Look at that. That's what we look like. So God's pulling on Simeon, and Simeon is what? He's digging his heels in a little bit. We've all done that. Let's go back to that verse. I still want to drag you one time. Now, really bear down, though, man. Sometimes God, you can give both hands. Sometimes God's got to get you a little bit. Look at it. I stepped on that rug. That was perfect. I got him. I set him up. How many of us have done just what we see? Probably today. Thank you, brother. That's a good man right there. Don't take that halter home with you. I'm messing with you. But he says, you must give up your what? You know how hard that really is? It sounds cool and it sounds religious in church, but that ain't no joke. You must give up your own way. Take up your cross and what? follow me. I'm looking for something right quick. I got a cross somewhere down there. Yeah, there we go. James is the police today. I got mine open. You're the one chewing a chew toy in church, so I don't know really what I'm going to do. This is a pretty solid cross. A friend of mine made this. I mean, it ain't no two before. It's pretty solid. Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you wants to follow, be my follower, you must give up your own way. That's where the mule throws Tony a lot of times. Take up your and do what? Follow me. Doesn't say take up your cross and do what you want to do and make the cross fit around your desires in life. Be real easy. That'd be fun, wouldn't it? Lord, this and we've all done that. How many of us have prayed pretty much what we wanted and said, God, you know, bless this thing? And actually, we should say, Lord, direct my steps. Have your way in my life. Whatever you want to do with me. Can I get a good amen? Job chapter 22, verse 21 through 23. This is a powerful set of verses. Submit to God, and you will have what? Man, that's pretty good. Let's just read it together. Submit to God and you will have peace. Then things will go well for you. The more I submit to him, the better off I'm going to be. The more I pull back, the worse it's going to be. This isn't rocket science, but every week we have to deal with this in our own personal lives. Because God is always going to be yanking your chain, so to speak. He's not going to be happy with you staying in your comfort zone long periods of time. We don't like to say amen, but it's true. Submit to God and you'll have peace. Then things will go well for you. Listen to his instructions and store them in your what? That's why you have got to get you a copy of God's word. I don't care how you read it, if it's on your phone or on the computer, and that's all good, but I suggest get you a written copy you can carry with you. You can make some marks in there, and you can write in your old East Texas terms, hey, what that means, amen? Notes in it. Verse 22 says, listen to his instructions and store them in your heart. Verse 23 is our last verse of the day. If you return to the Almighty, how many of us know sometimes we have to turn around and go back to him? If you return to the Almighty, you will be what? How many of you have seen God restore some things in your life? Could be your health, could be your life in general, a thousand different ways. If you return to the Almighty, you will be restored. Now, like this, so what? Clean up your life. You know, sometimes we just have to do a clean up. Any of you ever had a cleaned out your closet before? Nobody wants to make eye contact. One man was tough enough to raise his hand, but he wasn't looking at his wife. But we've all had a little clean up before. You know how I clean up? When Allison says, let's go to the dump, I'm about half minimalist. If I don't need it, I mean, I don't need it. So when she says, let's go to the dump and get rid of some things, I'm like, praise the Lord, we're taking the stock trailer. Think about it. They fine you in Angelina County if you don't have a tarp on your trailer. So I take a stock trailer. It's got a tarp already. Nothing comes out. We fill that trailer up, and we go to the dump, and they're like, oh, there comes the rednecks. Look, they're turning it in a cow trailer. But to me, the cow trailer is the perfect tool to take to the dump. You don't have to strap tarps on it, and it's ready to go. So he says, clean up your life, and we all have to clean up our life. I want to show y'all a picture of a man. Miss Cheryl will put that up for me. It is a man named Gary Glodden. You've heard me speak of Gary before. The picture is actually him sitting in a recliner with his wife. But Gary Glodden taught me so much. If you can see Mr. Gary there, he is probably, well, he is the greatest horseshoer I've ever been around. When I moved to Tulsa, Oklahoma to go to Bible school, I didn't know come here from Sikkim. You don't understand, I could barely trim a horse, and it looked like a stair step probably. It definitely wasn't level and right. Gary took a chance on me, and he hired me to be his apprentice. And actually, the first day when I asked him could I work for him, that I had a family and I was a hard worker, he didn't know me, so he said, I'm tired of hiring people, these kids, they won't work. And I told him, I said, I promise you this, I'll work. And he said, I ain't going to do it. So he said, no, I'm not going to hire you. Dadgummit, the next day, he called me. And he said, boy, And he called me a boy. That was good. He said, boy, he was 50 years old and I was 24. He said, I'm going to give you a chance. Man, I was so thankful. Can you see me locked up in town in a big city? You know, nothing wrong with it, just wasn't me working in Tulsa, you know. And before I hung up the phone, I said, Mr. Gary, I mean this humbly, but you won't regret hiring me. Thank you for giving me a chance. He's the greatest horseshoe I've ever known to this day. He taught me so much about shoeing horses. But more importantly, had nothing to do with a horse. Gary Glodin believed in me while I was in Bible school as a kid. And I couldn't speak in front of a crowd. I was scared to death. And when I graduated, he came to my graduation from a little old Bible school. And he said, he looked me in the eye. And I'll never forget, he gave me $100. That was like $1,000. And he said, whatever you do, boy, you're going to succeed. And every time I talk to him, he tells me that. You're going to succeed at whatever you do. Well, I got to work on some good horses for Gary Glodin. He's shooting them big barns in Tulsa. We'd go into cutting horse barns. How many of you remember a guy named a calf roper, a very famous calf roper named Mike Johnson? Mike Johnson lived around Henrietta. What I tell people now is I used to shoe his horses. Actually, what I did is I clenched the nails and pulled the old shoes off. But Gary shoed for lots of great, great, great horses. So I got to work on some top shelf horses as a young man, an apprentice under Gary. He's one of my heroes because he believed in me. Can I get a good amen? And I want to show you a video of a horse. It's about 29 seconds long. And when I say, are you broke or are you green broke, I want you to see this video of this horse because the shoe was a little wide. It was a unique shoe. So I had to take a hand grinder. That horse is about asleep. I'm grinding a shoe nailed on her foot. She ain't even tired. That's a wild one right there. How many of you want to ride that one? Now you think about that. I would say that horse is pretty broke. How many of you would not want me to grind on your horse's foot? Okay, amen. Thank you for telling me. Number one, I'm probably not going to try it. I don't even know why I done that other than for a sermon today. Yeah, isn't it? If you could just live with me for 3 days. Number one, you'd be wore out when I dropped you back off. Because God's always doing cool things with me. And dadgummit, I just stepped up to that horse and thought, she ain't going to move. And something just told me to do it. And I thought, you know, that'll preach Sunday. That horse was broke. Am I broke or am I claiming? See, I can learn how to talk Christianese. Praise God. Amen. I can throw that in on a phrase. But when the grinder's turned on, what am I going to do? Am I going to tear that fence down and run across 190 pulling a rope? Or am I going to be solid in my faith? So that right there exemplifies something that's broke. And I got one story and I'm going to have to let you go. I was at a customer's house the other day talking to a good friend of mine. We've been friends for years. And he told me a story about a horse. He said, do you remember that bay colt that I had? I said, I barely remember it. He said, man, I sold that horse to a man. He was broke. Broke, sold him to an older man, and the horse threw him off and broke all of his ribs. And man, that's terrible. You broke ribs. How many of you had broke ribs? Man. So he broke all of his ribs. He's felt bad. He said, I'm giving you your money back. I'm taking this horse back. And he said, I don't know what happened to that horse. But for some reason, ever since that day, I'm gonna get Doc over here. How many of y'all know this is church horse number two? It's Doc. Whoa. I spent 20 years of my life and I started shoeing crazy horses saying, whoa. Can you imagine how God thinks sometimes? How many times does he have to tell me and you, whoa. Because we're going to panic. Not me, Pastor Chet. I hope you make it till Monday, but you may not even make it till Monday until God says, whoa, whoa, whoa. He said, this horse from that day on would run away with you. And he said there was a little kid lived out in the community of Nogales Prairie in Apple Springs, if you know where that is, between Lufkin and Groveton. And he said there's this kid named Wade that loved a stupid horse. I said, how old was he? He said, oh, about 15, 16. I said, oh, now that makes sense. When you're that age, you ain't too worried about it. He said, that horse, he said, man, I'm telling you, he'd run away with you. And I'd pull his head around, and Jeffrey's a big old stout boy. Let's just say my foot's in a stirrup right here. I'd pull that horse's head around until he touched my foot. And he said he could run just as fast looking at my foot as he could when he was looking ahead. I said, well, what'd you do? He said, we beat him at his own game. He said, not me. I don't want none of it. I said, well, what'd you do? He said, I called this kid named Wade, and he said, tell you what I got, Wade. He said, his horse is running away. He said, I can't wait, Mr. Jeffrey. What day are we going to pin some cows? He said, well, we're going to pin some tomorrow. He said, well, I'll be there. I won't even charge you. They was in a 100-acre patch, which is pretty good size. And sure enough, they got started. Everything was fine. And in just a second, Obey starts to run away. And this kid just pulls him around. His head's right here by his knee. Horse is running wide open that way. And Jeffrey said, that's where I just start exiting the program. I don't want no more of it. So he just sucks him on around a little bit more and says, let's get it, buddy. And I'm going to show you. How many of you know what a set of split reins is? Mr. Robert Chapman, bless me. With this bit and headset, I called him yesterday. I was in Marlin, Texas. I said, Mr. Robert, how you doing? He said, I'm doing good. I'm feeding some cattle. Well, I said, when I call you, you don't never know what it is. He said, you got that right, son. I said, I need a set of weighted split reins, and dog, does he have them. Them are split reins, but if you look, they're thicker on the ends. And they're weighted, so if you're riding a horse, usually you'll split them there, run down each side, and that weight keeps them in your hands. And so I said, well, what did he do? He said, well, Wade brought his own little set of split reins with him when he got on this horse, and it ran away with him. And he said, when I seen Wade going over that hill, all I heard was, it'll be okay, Mr. Jeffrey, we'll be back in a little while. So when that horse bent his head around and run off with him and spit the bit, so to speak, Jeffrey said he took him split reins and worked that son of his tail over. And I want you to hear this. That'll get you. And sometimes we learn to throw fits with God. See, when a baby throws a fit, my kids threw fits a few times and realized it was not productive. All right? But the deal is, we learned, and a horse learns to throw a fit. The problem when a horse throws a fit, they're a little bit bigger project. So Wade, he's going down through there, and boy, he's working him over. He said, come on. He said, I could hear that kid saying, is that all you got? Come on with it. And they covered that 100 acres a time or two, and when they got back, that horse's nostrils was this big around. You ever needed air and couldn't get enough? That's what happened to that horse. He was blowing. And when they got back, now he said, we talking about, they circled this 100-acre pasture several times. And when he'd come back, he'd say, that ain't enough, baby. Come on with it. If you want to run, we're going to run. I laughed so hard listening to that because I wasn't dumb enough to hang on that long. Kid lived for it. He just let him go. He said, let's get it, man. Shoot, I ain't got to do nothing but set up here. And Jeffrey said he's about as easy to throw off as a tick. He wasn't going to come off. And so that horse just beat himself at his own game. He was blowing. And he said, I don't know how he done it, but he stayed on that sucker. And when he come back, that son come up there, and that horse dropped his head. And Wade dropped his reins, and that horse stood there like a champ. He was blowing. But sometimes we need a weighted rein on our hiney. Don't you know God sometimes gets tickled at us? What do? We bend our neck and try to run through the bit. When God is, sometimes God will put a test on you. Just see if you what we're going to do. We're going to follow him, or we're going to do our own thing. Can I get a good amen? Amen. And old Wade, he said, no problem. He used him split reins. He run that horse. And really, that horse was being counterfeit. You know what we all do sometimes? We look for the easy way out. That horse figured it out. Man, I just turned my head sideways and go to running off. They're going to get off me. We just had to find somebody crazy enough to ride him. Wouldn't be me. But you know what? Jesus ain't never been thrown off. And when you turn your head and open your mouth, you ever seen an old horse try to run through the bit and they showing their teeth and all that, boy? Ugh, gets on my nerves. And we do all that. We're showing out. Jesus is the ultimate cowboy. Amen. You ain't going to throw him off. You ain't going to shake him loose. And when you just think you're really wearing him out, he's going to come across that hind end a little bit with them split reins. Give you what you need. How many of you like to come up here as a visual example of this today? Tell you what, them reins ain't no joke, Mr. Robert. I hope your horse acts right, and if he don't, he will the next time, won't he? Amen. How many of us would agree we want to be broke? I want to be broke where God can grind my shoes a little bit. I don't want to be the old horse that runs out through the pasture when it gets hard. We learn anything today? I don't know how it can get any simpler than this. I'm closing with this, and I am sorry, but I'm going to owe you 3 minutes. I'll get back to you next week, I promise. Got 2 services. I heard a story this morning. A man was preaching that you might not expect who it would be. He was sharing a testimony that he knew personally a homeless man that had inherited $70,000. He was a young man and didn't handle it well, and got on dope, got on booze, and got on all kinds of bad choices. None of us ever made any bad choices here, right? He made all these bad choices, and he found himself homeless. And all that he ever had left after being homeless for several years was a backpack. And his mama raised him in church. She loved him, even when all this happened, and he inherited this little bit of money, $70,000, which is a lot of money, but if you start going through it, it don't last no time. And so his mama had given him a Bible when he was a teenager that was wrote a letter in there how much she loved him. Can I get a good amen for the mamas? Mamas don't give up. Daddies don't either, hopefully. Wrote a letter to him how much she loved him and said, actually, son, this is my love letter to you, but this Bible is God's love letter to you. He finds himself homeless, and through all the deals and bad choices and bad places he found himself in, eventually he lost his backpack for a couple of years. And a man in Atlanta decided to hire this kid, and he was kind of starting to cry out to God. You know, sometimes you got to hit the bottom. None of us have been there, but we know people that have, right? He hits bottom, and he says, God, help me. And a man hired him and said 100 miles away, this man had bought 2 abandoned apartments. This is a true story. Bought 2 abandoned apartments, and he sent this man and one other guy to go clean up these apartments. So he's cleaning up this apartment, and when he gets in there and starts cleaning up, he finds his backpack. And he said, there ain't no way that Bible's in there. Unzipped it, and he found the Bible that his mama gave him 100 miles away in an abandoned apartment. And I'm going to close with this verse. We're done. Psalms 136, verse 23. He remembered us in our... It makes me want to cry just reading that. He remembered us in our weakness. His faithful love, what? Endures forever. Aren't you glad that God remembered you in your weakest times? I don't care who you are, how good a Christian you are, you've had some weak times. At some point, buddy, you have spit the bit and you've turned your neck around and you've run off. But you ain't going to throw Jesus off. He'll dig. Another thing Jeffrey said, that son of a gun was going wide open. And he was talking to the horse saying, bring it on, baby. And he was spurring him a little bit too. So if you want to run, let's just get it. And after a few laps of that 100 acres, and you know that's what I just described all of us. So I got a word for you today from God. You ready? From a country boy, stop running if you are running. And if you're even thinking about running, don't do it. Even if you're turning your head a little bit, getting ready to run off. Jesus is the greatest cowboy to ever live. You can't run from him. Psalm says you can go to the heavens, he's there. If you go to the depths of the earth, he's there. If you go to the mountains or the hills or the valleys, he's there. Can we get a good amen today? So look at your neighbor and say, don't run off. Lord, thank you for this word today. Speak to our hearts today. If you don't know Jesus, today is the day. Make sure he's the Lord of your life. It's pretty simple. I'm going to pray a prayer with you that I prayed 31 years ago. Oh God, I realize that I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. And I ask you to have your way in my life, Lord Jesus. And I don't want to play games with you. And I don't want to turn my head and get stiff-necked and run off with you. Because you're just going to ride all the way there and all the way back. You never leave us and you never forsake us. We love you, Lord. We give you our life. We ask you to come into our hearts. If somebody don't know you today, pray this prayer with me. Jesus, come into my heart and be my Lord and Savior. I give you my life. Take the reins of my life and do with me what you see fit. You got a purpose for me, and I'm surrendering to you today and submitting in Jesus' name. Everybody said? Now I'm going to pray something else, and we're done. Lord, for us that are believers, Lord, may we never run off. If we do, may you pull our head around and wear us out till you get us back where we need to be. Because we done tried all this mess on our own, and it didn't work out too good. That's why we're here. So we love you, Lord. Keep us lined out, Lord, in Jesus' name. Everybody say it? I'm going to run the back and shake some hands. I went over 4 minutes or five.